contributed to the success in materializing the paper. I am indeed delighted to be here, as this is my first time addressing this dialogue since my appointment as the Chief of Defence Force. This year, we are on another chapter of our journey in materializing the vision of the white paper. It is an excellent opportunity for me to share my insight in charting the course for the Malaysian Armed Forces to safely navigate through the future challenges as outlined in the white paper. I could not agree more on the strategic outlook laid out in the white paper, as it is not my intention to dwell more on it. But in a nutshell, the Malaysian Armed Forces is not only operating in challenging and complex times, but it is also facing competing budgetary priorities, aging asset, and the rise of non-traditional security challenges. Besides all this, the Malaysian Armed Forces is also required to be engaged in military operations other than war or mutau. While Malaysia upholds the principle of prosper, thee never, that is in line with the principle of zone of peace, freedom, and neutrality, also known as ZOFAN, a revolution in military affairs is indeed crucial for the armed forces to remain relevant and efficient. It is not only obtaining new technologies, but also developing appropriate doctrine, operational concept, and force structure to ensure that we are ever ready in time of need. As such, in order to meet state-of-the-art demand and perhaps ramification, we require a blueprint of force structure in line with the needs to transform toward becoming an integrated, agile, and focused armed forces. This, as you all may be aware, is reflected in our very first defense white paper. The paper is a roadmap for the Malaysian Armed Forces' long-term capability development effort, vis-a-vis in ensuring its readiness to meet the growing complex and multi-dimensional challenges confronting us today and in the future. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most durable outcomes of this white paper is Government of Malaysia's commitment to pursue the three pillars of defence strategy, namely concentric, deterrent, comprehensive security and credible partnership in line with the Malaysia vision as a secure, sovereign and prosperous nation. Together, these three pillars support our position as a maritime nation with continental route between the Asia-Pacific and Indian Ocean region. Each pillar is being pursued in ways that position Malaysia to maximize our potential as a bridging linchpin between the two ocean regions, turning our geographical advantages into strategic and development dividend. The first pillar